Dice are an integral part of board games. Whether you're playing Monopoly, Snakes and Ladders, or countless other games, a set of dice often has a critical place in the box. Most often, the word dice brings to mind a six-sided cube, but the world of dice is broader than these common square forms numbered 1 through 6. So, what are dice exactly? In mathematical terms, a die can have any number of sides. Going to the extreme, a die with infinite sides would shape into a perfect sphere. Through that same lens, golf balls technically qualify as dice, though they probably wouldn't make for very fair gameplay. This leads us to the concept of fair dice, which ensure that each side has an equal probability of appearing on a throw. In the gaming world, fair dice are meticulously created to maintain balance, favoring no single outcome over others. For our purpose, the term dice refers only to these types of mathematically accurate, game-friendly tools. We also encounter non-cubic dice, famously associated with the game Dungeons & Dragons. These polyhedral dice generate a wider range of outcomes. Intriguingly, you can also introduce these unusual dice to classic board games for altered gameplay. Dice aren't just limited to 6 faces. There are dice with even fewer sides, including those with just 2. These might not sound familiar until you hear their more common name, coins. Coins offer a simple die roll with only 2 outcomes, and are frequently used in games. Stepping up the complexity, dice also come in 3-sided prism forms. Cultural history reveals dice of varying facets. 4-sided dice, with significant mythological implications, have been used in Indian games such as Pachisi and Chaupar since ancient times. More complex varieties include 8-sided octahedral dice, 10-sided pentagonal trapezohedral dice, commonly used in role-playing games, and 12-sided dice based on the Platonic solid dodecahedron. These were found among ruins of Greek and Roman civilizations and are still used today in tabletop role-playing games and mathematical puzzles. Historians even uncovered a 20-sided dice type known as icosahedron in ancient Roman archaeological sites. But the world of dice doesn't stop there. There are even more complex dice, with faces adding up to 24, 28, or 30. The rarer the dice, the likelier it is to be an impractical choice. These uncommon variations often keep rolling when thrown due to their shape, barring some external force. For instance, a 60-sided die often falls short in game functionality due to its excessive momentum. A 100-sided die fares slightly better. Its hollow interior and external ridges provide friction, enabling it to eventually stop in a satisfactory manner. Unbelievably, there are even 120 and 144-sided dice. So, as you gear up for your next family vacation board game, imagine the potential of bringing in an unusual new die, adding even higher levels of fun and unpredictability. If you like this video, then please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more stories on science and our lives. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us.